Hey guys, today we're modeling in Revit the CCTV headquarters by OMA or Rem Koolhaas. Awesome building in China, and we're going to be looking at everything from bringing in the reference images, levels, reference planes, modeling the solids, modeling the voids, and then adjusting those so it's just perfect. So let's get straight into it. So we're starting with an elevation. Let's go to our south elevation, double click that. And the first thing we're going to do is import an image. Bang, drag that in, boom, we've got our image. Now we need to scale it. So come in here. First thing is to move it. So pick a ground level point and just move it, drop it with that level one. And now let's scale this building. So if we come up here to resize or scale, pick this level one, and I can see the highest point here that we want to come to is this 234 meters. So if we pick somewhere below that on level one, and come up here and then pick as close as we can to that point, and then just type in 234 meters, enter, ZF to zoom fit, and we can see now that's 234 up there. We've got our levels down here still. You can see those quite tiny. What we're going to do to make those bigger, change the scale 1 to 500. That should do it. Now we can select these and pull these out like that, and this out like that, and start to update these levels to match the levels on our reference. So 46.45 meters. And if I select this one, I'm just going to copy it up. So copy, make sure multiple is ticked on. You can actually tick on constrain also. Now let's grab this, pick from here, roughly there, there, and there. And now if we zoom in, we can actually give them more exact dimensions. 161 meters, 213.9 meters, and 234 meters. Perfect. Now at this point we can actually jump into our plan. So let's go to our site plan. I might just hide this off with my shortcut, and then we can drag in a plan image. Drag that in, drop it, and we can now scale this to suit. So first thing we want to do is get this orientated right. So you can see here there's a long side and a short side, and this is kind of even, but if we look at our south elevation, very clearly this is our long side here at the front left. So we want to bring that in the site plan down to the bottom left by rotating. So rotate and spin this around 90 degrees. Boom, so we've got that long side down the bottom left or the front left. So it makes sense, matches our south elevation. Next, we've got to set the scale. So if we go to our south elevation again, let's just throw in two quick reference planes up here. And we'll do one from there, like that. And I might just drag this down here. What we can do is just copy this across. So copy, and let's take it from here right until that point there. So this is the overall width. If we go back to our site plan, we can see those two reference planes there for our overall width. And all we need to do now is firstly select the image, move, and throw this onto there. And I might, while we're here, just extend these reference planes. And the way we can do that, you can actually zoom in so you can pick this circle and hold the left click down, but if you scroll at the same time with your mouse, you can actually zoom out to make this quite a lot bigger, so something like that. Same with this one, or you can try and be really careful with picking like that, and then throw that up there. So this now here is good. We want to scale it out, so I'm going to come up here and go to resize, pick from this reference right down to that edge there, and then click on the bar reference plane there. And I might just, holding down shift and nudging with the up button on my keyboard, we can move that into position. Grab now these elevations, and same thing again with the keyboard, just move these into position, just outside of the building, outside of the reference planes, like that. You can also use your mouse if you like. That might be easier. Perfect. Now if we go back to our south elevation, We can actually add some more images in here or mass in here, but I'm going to rather mass from our site plan. So back to our site plan. Let's start the mass. Massing in site, in place mass. Okay. And we have our levels in here, so we can go straight to our rectangle. We don't even need any more reference planes here. We're going to start by modeling the overall form. All we need to do is make sure we're on level one, and then let's do from this point, click, and then make sure you come down that reference plane, and you want that left edge in line with the edge of the building, like that. So that's our base. And then we want to also model the top. So the top is a little bit more, we don't have a clear, we can't see exactly where that top is. So for that, we need to go to our south elevation and add some more reference planes. So we can go in here, plane, and we can go from this point, like that, and another one from here. Let's go from there down to there, like that. And if we go now to our site plan, we can see those two reference planes there. And all we need to do is select this one and mirror it from this point, 45 degrees. So we've got that corner there. And the same with this one on this edge. So up here, mirror from there, 45 degrees, like that. Now we can go back to our rectangle and draw the top. So level 5, and it's just really simple, just snapping to those intersections. Note that we've got this warning, we can't see it in this floor plan, so I'll show you why. Let's just finish that for a second, go to our 3D view just to show you that it is actually there. Zoom out, you can see that there, we've drawn those two planes, but in the site plan we cannot see it. The reason we cannot see it is because of our view range. So we come here to edit, and we know that our building is about 230 something meters tall, so I'm going to set the top here to, let's just say, 250 meters. And the cut plane also to 250 meters and hit OK. And now there we go, voila, we can see that top section there. Going back to our 3D view, just to make this a solid, we select this, edit in place, and select both of these, create form, solid form. We have our overall form without any voids. Next step, let's create those voids. There's two of them. Let's start with the first and the easiest, so site plan. Switch this to wireframe so that we can see our image underneath. And the first one we're going to do is this bottom right hand corner, this void here, and we can see it in this plan. So I'm going to go to our rectangle. We're going to draw the first one because it goes from level one. So from the bottom, we're going to go level one from this point. And then I'm coming up and I want this point here and this point here to be aligned. So I just move that rectangle up until it is perfectly aligned with both, and that seems pretty spot on to me, so I'm going to click to finish that, escape, and then another rectangle, set this placement plane up at level 3, so level 3, and then we want to make sure that it matches these points here. So again, from this corner, and bring it up, I want it to match that point, and I want it to match that point. So make sure that my rectangle fits both of those like that perfectly. Hit escape. Let's go to 3D view to have a look at what we've done again. So we've got this rectangle here, and if I hold down control and click, we've got that rectangle down there. And we can now also create form. And I'm going to create a solid form here just to show you. So that's basically what we've got in there, and we want it to cut from the original form. So all we need to do is come down here and change it from solid to void, like that. And the reason why I'm just going to control Z just to show you. The reason why we create a solid first is just to see exactly what it looks like, and it makes it a lot easier. If we want to adjust it, we can do that a lot easier when it's a solid rather than when it is a void. So if I just select that again, just to repeat and make that a void, and just click anywhere, and that is done. Now let's do the other void, which is a little bit more difficult, but not really that much more difficult. We're going to use these lines again. Hey guys, just a quick one to please subscribe, make sure you hit that bell to get notified, then leave a like and a comment and share with your friends. Let's get back to the video. So rectangle, and we're going to start this one at level 2, and we can see here it starts at this point, but that doesn't really matter as much. What matters is that it ends in line with these here. So I'm actually going to start it from out here and bring it in to that point right about there, like that. And then we want to create a top. Let's change this here to level 5, like that. And then let's go here and put that out to there. Let's go to our 3D view and have a look. We've got this there. We can select it and go create form, solid form, like that. Now we want to come to our south elevation just to make sure this is looking correct. So you can see here that if we set this to wireframe, we can actually see that that is pretty much spot on. So we're happy with that. We can cut that void. It was more really just a check to make sure that's okay. Tab there, make this a void, and voila, there we go. We have a perfect CCTV tower, finished mass. At this point, if you want to add floors, walls, and the rest of it, it's really simple. We've done it in a lot of other tutorials. I'm not going to go over it again here. You can check those out, but all you need to do is basically, you know, the process, select mass floors, and then architecture, wall by face, or curtain system. And then also you can create floors by face also in here once you've got those masses in there. So just hide these off, zoom fit, there we go. Thanks again for watching, guys. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell to get notified. Please leave a like and a comment, and make sure you share it with a friend that might be interested. Otherwise, check out the links on screen and in the description below for more, and I will see you in the next video.